In this video, I show you how I design a poster concept in Adobe XD. I had an idea, the concept of looking at the world with rose-colored glasses, and for fun, I decided I wanted to create a poster concept out of this. A quick note here, if you're designing a poster that you intend to print out large and high quality, you wouldn't actually want to design it in Adobe XD. For that, I would recommend using a combination of Illustrator and Photoshop. For one, you would want to be able to specify your artboard size in inches and adjust the DPI to 300 for printing. Adobe XD is a screen design tool, not ideal for print. However, since this is just a creative concept and exercise that I'm doing, I wanted to challenge myself and use Adobe XD to see how far I could take a creative concept, and also to prove how much you can do and create within this program. I started out by looking for reference images of sunglasses. I lowered the opacity of the image and then used the pen tool to draw on top of it. When you're drawing something that's symmetrical, you only need to draw one side, which is what I did with one of the lenses here. Then you can use the Add tool to combine them into one shape. Once you join the shapes together, you want to essentially outline them so that they are truly one shape. To do this, go to Object, Path, Convert to Path, or use keyboard shortcut Command 8. If you're new to using the pen tool in any program, a couple of tips. Don't worry about getting the shape right from the start. Instead, just start laying down some of the anchor points. You can always adjust them later. If you double-click on an anchor point, you can toggle between angles and curves. You can also just click on one and delete it to simplify your shape. Err on the side of creating less rather than more anchor points. The more anchor points you have in a shape, the less smooth the lines will look. I like to name my layers as I go, so I named each of the shapes to make them more identifiable. These photos on the top of my canvas are some inspiration that I pulled from Pinterest, with color palettes I might use for the design. To add interest to the design, I'm adding type that says "Hello World." I'm going for a retro vibe for this design, so it's key that the typeface reflects this. This first typeface is called Lust Script. It has a fun and feminine feel to it, but not quite retro. It's also a little bit difficult to read. So I went back to Adobe Fonts to search for another typeface. I ended up going with this one called Whomp. When I saw these display images, I was instantly sold. This had the right energy that I was looking for. When you find a typeface you like on Adobe Fonts, be sure to check the box for activating it. Then you should be able to officially use it in all of your Adobe Suite programs. Next, it's time to add a background to the design, which will be the world that someone is looking at. I was pretty sure from the start that I wanted this to be a cityscape photo. I started off with this one of New York City. With another rectangle shape on top of the image, I played around with adding a gradient and using multiply and other blending modes. I felt like the color of the photo was competing with the gradient, so I decided to take that photo into Photoshop and use a black and white adjustment filter and adjust the brightness and contrast to make it more dramatic. I continued to play around with the blending modes. Then I double-clicked into one of the lenses and copy and pasted that shape to create a blur effect. To do so, all you have to do is check the box for background blur in the appearance panel. I went back and forth with the decision, thinking that the background photo should be black and white and the lenses of the glasses should be that rose color, but it just didn't seem as compelling as a color city photo. And I started to not like how the photo looked with the Empire State Building in the middle of one of the lenses. It looked kind of odd with the blur effect. So you'll see me switching back and forth through many different city photos, trying to find the one that works the best. I would have liked to include a photo of San Francisco, but the similar thing of the Transamerica pyramids sticking up just didn't look good with the composition. For a split second, I even thought about changing the background to bright, fluffy, colorful clouds. But I didn't think this was as interesting or impactful, so I went back to a city. I think what finally made me decide on this photo is because it's more of a ground level shot, whereas a lot of the other ones were aerial shots and it just looked funny for someone to be looking out from that angle. This is a little bit more realistic, and also there was just so much more detail in the photo. And once again, I played around with different color overlays and blending modes, trying to get the right amount of balance in that city background photo. I played around with changing the color of the frames, and I really liked how this bright yellow looked. It added just the right amount of contrast and pop. Overall, I really like how this color version looked, but I decided to create another version, so I copied over the same artboard and test out creating another version. You always want to try to create more than one version of anything that you're designing, just so that you can play out all the different options and see what looks best. With the black and white photo, I was able to control the color overlays better. I tried different blending modes. I even tried using a radial gradient instead of a linear one. But I ended up removing all of the color overlays and sticking with the black and white photo and changing the color of the lenses to reflect more of that rose color to further enforce the concept of looking at the world through rose-colored glasses. I tested adding the option of a blur to the entire background, but that didn't really make sense and you lost all the interest that the city photo brings to the composition. I made the sunglasses a little bit larger so that they were more of a focal point. And a little thing about Adobe XD here, when you're selecting multiple shapes like this, sometimes it doesn't scale them all correctly. So you'll notice that there's these little gaps where the lenses should meet. Unfortunately, there's nothing you can do about it. It's just an annoying thing about the program. And here are the final designs. A side-by-side comparison of the color and black and white version. And I also created a vertical version. This wasn't my favorite at first because I knew I needed to crop the glasses and I didn't feel like it was as impactful as the horizontal version, but it kind of gives you the feel that you are actually wearing the glasses. Let me know which version, horizontal or vertical, and color or black and white is your favorite by leaving a comment below. If you enjoyed this kind of video and found it helpful or inspiring, give it a like, leave a comment below letting me know, and subscribe for more. By the way, I also created a 15-second Instagram reel version of this video. It's a super quick time lapse of the entire process. I'll leave a link in the description below if you want to check out the Instagram reel and follow me there.